Today we've got a couple of power supplies from Traco Power in Switzerland. One is an open frame model in a power dense 3x5 inch format. The other is enclosed. These are called 450 series because they can provide 450 watts when they have forced air cooling and up to 320 watts when they rely on conduction for cooling. For forced air cooling, you can see the fan mounted on the enclosed version. We've powered up the open frame model and set it up with the dummy loads so you can get a feel for how it performs. You can also see our 20 ohm dummy load here. The open frame version we've powered up also has the ability to run a 12 volt fan via a fan connection available on this auxiliary connector.
These supplies have medical certifications along with IEC UL 62368-1 approval for more general purpose uses. They all limit earth leakage current to below 100 microamps, which lets them handle body floating applications. Other operational parameters that come out of their medical certification include operation to at least an altitude of 5,000 meters and meeting a workmanship standard called IPCA 610 Class 3, which is more stringent than the default standard. They also have IEC 60601-1 3rd Edition safety approval and comply with the ISO 14971 risk management and 60601-1-2 4th edition electromagnetic compatibility specs.
We've connected a scope to the supply output to give you something to look at as we operate the supply. There are a couple of interesting features that are available from what's called the auxiliary connector. We've already mentioned the connections available to run a fan, but when you receive the ply from Traco Power, it will probably come with the jumper between the two pins on the auxiliary connector. One of those pins is what's called a remote pin, and the other is a sense pin. Jumpering the two together allows the supply to power up as soon as there is AC on its input. There are plus and minus remote control pins on the connector, as well as plus and minus remote sense pins. The two remote pins implement a remote control feature used to turn the output voltage on or off.
The point of this feature is to reduce input power if the system is in idle or sleep mode. This feature is useful for cycling the output power without having to cycle the input power. That helps reduce the AC inrush current and extend the life of an external circuit breaker or input fuse if the supply is in a system that uses them.
The remote control feature gives us a chance to show the supply startup time, which is listed as a maximum of 2 seconds. You can see we are getting less than that when we turn it on with the remote feature. The aux connector also provides two standby pins used to sequence the system's input power in cases where there are supplies besides this one in the system. This feature will reduce the total inrush current of the system as well. The standby pins supply a 5 volt signal and can deliver up to 2 amps to external circuits as might be used during a wake up event at the system level. And it can be used to power up the remote control feature as well.
Finally, there are two sense pins in the auxiliary connector used to compensate for power losses in long load cables, so you can get output voltage regulation at the load rather than at the converter's output terminal. The remote sense feature can compensate output voltage drops of up to a half volt. We'll show one other parameter of the supply that you can view on a scope. The supply we have today is a 24 volt model, and it has a ripple and noise spec of 240 millivolts peak to peak typical. We can check that out by zooming in on the DC output waveform. You can see the noise arising from the supply switching action, and you can also see it is way below the listed typical value.
All in all, this is a pretty solid supply that has a lot of features that could come in handy in a variety of applications. And that's about all the time we have for today. For more information, visit eeworldonline.com or tracopower.com. Thanks for watching.
Oh,